Good morning everyone. Odisha IAS Academy welcomes you in the series of MCQs based on daily current affairs for helping you in the upcoming exam of UPSC Prelims 2020. So today we will discuss MCQs of 18th March, but before that you can download these PPTs from the link given in the description box below. And please take a pause when you see questions on the screen and answer it first, then see the explanation part. And if you feel the video is going too slow, too fast, please adjust the speed of the video accordingly and utilize your time properly. So work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos and try to get at least 7 questions correct out of 10. So let's begin our today's MCQs and increase your accuracy level. So question number 1 is with reference to Epidemic Diseases Act 1897. First, the act aims at better prevention of the spread of dangerous epidemic diseases. Second, the provisions of the act are precautionary only with no punishable offense. So here, statement first is correct, second is incorrect. So option will be A, one only. So let's check out explanation part. So the act was made to provide better prevention for the spread of dangerous epidemic diseases. And the law was first enacted to tackle bubonic plague in Bombay state, which was in former British India. And the central government may prescribe regulation for the inspection of any ship or vessel leaving or arriving at any port or for such detention of any person intending to sail therein or arriving thereby. And it provides for the inspection of persons travelling by railway or otherwise, and segregation in hospital, temporary accommodation of persons suspected, and any person disobeying the provision of the act shall deem to have conducted punishable offence under section 188 of Indian Penal Code. So because this is a colonial law, you could have easily eliminated statement second, and the context is Act has been invoked in all state and UTs of India following the outbreak of coronavirus. Now question number 2 is with reference to Cashmere Forest Disease. So first, the disease is endemic to the Indian subcontinent. Second, rodents and monkeys are the vectors of the disease. So here statement first is incorrect, second is correct. So option will be B, second only. Let's check out explanation part. So here you can see it is endemic to South India, not whole Indian subcontinent. And the disease is a tick-borne virus, hemorrhagic fever endemic to South India, and it is caused by Cashmere Forest Disease virus, which is a member of virus family Salviviridae, and CFDV was identified in 1957 and it was isolated from a sick monkey from Cashmere Forest in Karnataka, and transmission to human may occur after a tick bite or contact with an infected animal like rodent or monkeys, and the disease have a fatal rate of 3 to 10%, in effect 400 to 500 people annually. And the context is research center on KFT has been proposed to be established in Sagar city of Karnataka. That's why it is in news. Now question number 3 is with reference to palm oil. So first, palm oil import was placed among the top 5 commodities imports of India. Second, it is the cheapest edible oil available naturally. So here both the same statements are correct. So option will be C. So India has cut import duty on crude palm oil and refined, bleached and deodorized palm oil, and has moved RBD oil from free to restricted list of imports. And India imports around 64 lakh metric tons of CPO and 33.9 lakh metric tons of RBD in 2018 and 2019, bulk of which are from Indonesia. And Malaysia exports 25.8% of palm oil to India, and it is the India's 5th most valuable import after mineral oil, gold, coal and telecom instruments such as cell phones. And it is the cheapest edible oil available naturally, and stays relatively stable in high temperatures and therefore suitable for reuse and deep frying, and it is main ingredient in vanaspati, which is hydrogenated vegetable oil. Now next question. Now question number 4 is Pradhan Mantri Ujwala Yojana is an initiative of which of the following ministry? So the correct ministry is Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. So option will be B here. So this Yojana was rolled out in 2016 and it is an initiative of Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, and the scheme is no longer running as it has met the target of providing LPG connection to 8 crore beneficiaries from below poverty line. And as per recent parliamentary report, only 3 states and 5 union territories, that is Haryana, Punjab and Andhra Pradesh as a state, and union territories of Delhi, Chandigarh, Daman and Diu, Dadar Nagar Haveli, Andaman and Nicobar and Pondicherry could become kerosene free under the scheme. So this one you should be noting. And the allocation for the scheme has been cut down by 58% this year as compared to last year. Data is not that much important. You should be knowing the trend. Now question number 5 is, Namda carpet weaving in news recently is practiced in which of the following region in India? So the correct one is Punjab and Jammu and Kashmir actually. So option will be B here. It is not related with Punjab. So here you can see the image, and the Namda making is a rare and unique craft of Jammu and Kashmir, wherein splendid floor pieces are made from wool by practice of felting the wool rather than weaving it, and it is used as traditional matting spread on the floor to adorn homes. And the art of Namda making was brought to Kashmir by the Sufi saint Shah-e-Hamdan, who came with the generous mission of bringing livelihood to the local Kashmiris. And the context is the story of Arifa from Jammu and Kashmir, who has received the traditional Namda craft of carpet weaving, was shared through PM Modi's social media handle under the theme "She Inspires Us" on the occasion of International Women's Day on 8th March. That's why it is a new and becoming important. Now question number 6 is, consider the following terminologies and their respective meanings. So first, a pandemic is worldwide spread of new disease that affect large number of people. Second, an endemic is a regional outbreak of an illness that spread unexpectedly. Third, social distancing refers to the measures that are taken to increase the physical space between people to slow the spread of the virus. Statement 4, the incubation period is the time it takes for symptoms to appear after a person is infected. So here, all the given statements are correct. So option will be D, all of the above. You should be knowing this. And recently, WHO declared the coronavirus outbreak as a pandemic after it spread across 6 continents and more than 100 countries. And the WHO has avoided using the word earlier because it did not want to give the impression that the disease was unstoppable. And the technical name of the coronavirus is SARS-CoV-2, so do remember it. And the respiratory disease it causes has been named the coronavirus disease 2019 or COVID-19. Don't get confused between the two. Now next question. Now question number 7 is with reference to white giraffes which were in news. So consider the following statement. First, the white appearance of the giraffe is due to albinism. Second, the population decline among giraffes is due to habitat loss, civil unrest, poaching and ecological issues. Third, white giraffe is a very rare species of giraffe. So here statement first is incorrect, all are correct. So option will be A, one only, because this one is incorrect one. So this is the image of the white giraffe, and first is incorrect because the condition leucasium led to the white color of this giraffe, and the condition of leucasium is different from albinism because of which animals lack melanin throughout their body. And the leucasium on the other hand is partial and led to pale or patchy coloration of the skin, hair, feathers, scales or cuticles, but not on the eyes. This white color is due to leucasium, and essentially unlike albino animals, leucistic animals retain some essence of their normal pigmentation. Now next question. Now question number 8 is, recently Epidemic Disease Act 1897 was in use. I hope you can answer it correctly. So first, act was introduced to tackle the epidemic of bubonic plague in the erstwhile Bombay Presidency in 1890s. Second, historians have criticized the act for its potential for abuse. So ironically, both the statements are correct. So option will be C here. So using powers conferred by the act, colonies authorities would search suspected plague cases in home and among passengers with forceful segregation, evacuation and demolition of infected places. And the act, which consists of four sections, aims to provide for a better prevention of the spread of dangerous epidemic disease. Also, section 2 empowers state governments and UTs to take special measures and formulate regulations for containing the outbreak. Now question number 9 is, recently the term resource politics was in news. So consider the following statement and you have to choose the incorrect one. So in the given one, the incorrect one is C. It is the first incident where resource politics has happened in Madhya Pradesh. And C is incorrect because resource politics is referred to many incidences in Indian politics where police are sent away to luxurious resort either to cause or prevent a power upset. And the resort politics is a curiously Indian phenomena, and party MLAs are usually secluded at luxurious hotels or resorts to prevent horse trading. I hope you knowing the word horse trading. Now question number 10 is, Kuril Islands separate which of the following water bodies? So the correct one is A here, C of Kotsak and Pacific Ocean. More you can see in the image. Here are the Kuril Islands and its separate Pacific Ocean is Sea of Okhotsk, and the Kuril Islands form part of ring of tectonic instability encircling the Pacific Ocean, referred to as a ring of fire. So here I am wrapping up today's MCQ. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. And in the last, positive quotation is, you will never know your limits until you push yourself to them. So work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos. Please download these PPTs and do multiple revision of these PPTs. Also subscribe our channel. We will meet tomorrow with the next MCQ. So stay safe, stay healthy, and thank you.